Next up is the programs, some of these great tools that are that we have here in Rails, which is Cucumber and Capybara. So my view, it'd be interesting to see what other people think. I think Cucumber is the shining tool of Rails. It's the one that when I learned about it, I said, wow, this is really pretty impressive piece of technology. As opposed to some of the other tools, well, there's versions of it in other languages. This one, I don't think there's anything else like it. So what's the big idea? So now that we know about the user stories, which are on these 3x5 cards, and get the acceptance tests. And so now what we have to do is see if we can get the, is what we're trying to figure out a way is to get a tool that'll help us take us the stuff on the 3x5 cards and the actual testing code. Well, that seems like a pretty big gap to cross. So what Cucumber does is kind of meet this halfway between the developer and the customer. That's what the real challenge is. So it places some restrictions on the user stories so that's understandable to the customer, but so they don't look like code, but they aren't completely freeform. You're not saying, well, you can write anything you want in the card, and we'll figure out how to, it can't have an AI complete program that has to understand what's going on. So by placing some restrictions in the user stories, Cucumber, amazingly enough, makes the tie between what non-technical customers do and stuff you can test. So let's go specifically for the example here. So this is the format that the slight restrictions on what can be in a user story for Cucumber. And they've changed the words a little bit. So feature, there's one feature for a user story. User can manually add a movie. That's our example here. You see the keyword scenario in Cucumber, there can be one or more scenarios. Typically there's several scenarios. We'll just do one example here. One scenario per feature. And then what's below that are called steps. So each one of those lines is a step. I guess in this case there are 8 lines. So that's the compromise that to be able to use Cucumber, you force these user stories to be in this form, but you can imagine if you're non-technical friends, if you gave them an example, that doesn't seem all that restrictive. Just you have to start these sentences with given, when, and then for the steps. Scenario is the name of the thing that you're doing. You may have multiple scenarios for a given feature. So that's the restrictions. And this slide just repeats it. So a user story has one feature. A feature has one or more scenarios. And in the Cucumber language, you use the keywords feature and scenario to identify the feature and scenario. And then the scenario itself has these steps and will use a different set of keywords. We've already seen these. Given is the keyword that says, is trying to capture the state of the world before an event. These are preconditions. So you're writing down the givens to set up the scenario. When represents the event itself, like you push a button. So given, you got the preconditions. When this happens, and then not surprisingly, the next word is then. So the preconditions, when I do this, then what happens afterwards. The expected results are true. So those are the three main words you use. Now, there's times when you want to have more complicated givens or more complicated whens or more complicated thens in particular. And so they add these extra conjunctions here, and but. I don't think I've ever seen a scenario with but, that it's a legal thing to use. And is a very common place to get more complicated. So still looks like English. Still understandable non-technical customer, but this is what you're trying to capture. So it's going back to the connextra format and making it a way that we're going to be able to do it. So here's the magic here. So the user stories are kept in one or more sets of files. These are called step files. Okay, so it considers the steps. There's a separate set of files that has the Ruby code to test these steps. These are step definitions. So we have step files and step definitions. And you can think of the relationship here as like the relationship between method definitions and method calls. So method definitions are the step definitions, and the steps of the scenarios are like method calls. So that's the relationship there. And how do we do that? How do we, cross that barrier? How do we cross the gap between the steps and the step definitions? And we're using regular expressions. So we use regular expressions to parse the English phrases to capture that gap. So This is, we saw, you all know regular expressions by now. So a given, and this is the regular expression that we're trying to match. And you can see this, it starts at the start of the line, and it may have the phrase I, am on, and then here is a regular expression that you're capturing using the capture thing, and then the end of the line. So this one, this phrase would match. I am on, and then the Rotten Potatoes homepage would be captured here, and so that would get the match. So that, but this is the big idea. We'll use regular expressions to go from the steps that you write, that lots of steps in the scenarios, to the step definitions, and that'll do the matching. Now, what does Cucumber do with that? Now that it's made the matching, that mapping between them, what Cucumber does is it tries to execute, it makes those mappings together and tries to run them, and then it'll give you color feedback of what happened. If the step passes the test, it paints it green, and I believe that's where the name Cucumber came from. Person who came up with Cucumber, his girlfriend gave him the name, called it Cucumber, and I think it's came green for passing. Yellow means it's not implemented, and red is for failing. What will actually happen if it runs into a failing step, all the steps thereafter will be colored blue because they're skipped. And the goal then is to make all the steps green so that they all pass. So that's the magic of Cucumber. All right, so that's, how do you invoke the app? How do you get to go through the scenarios? That's another program called Capybara. So we need this. There's lots of examples of this. The current one is Capybara. That's the kind of what happens in Rails. The people are inventing new tools all the time. So we need a tool that pretends to be the user following the scenarios of a user story. We need something to act out the user stories. Capybara is that program. What it does is it simulates a browser. It can interact with the app receiving pages. It can parse the HTML and submits form as a user would. So it's pretending to be a user interacting with the browser, invoking your application. There's lots of these kind of programs. Capybara has a restriction, is that it cannot handle JavaScript. So it's a nice, simple program. It's pretty fast. You need a different program to handle JavaScript. In this case, this is a program called WebDriver that can handle the JavaScript as well, but it's a lot slower. So people will use Capybara when they can and only use WebDriver when they have to. Okay, I think we will get started on the demo and then see how we're doing in time. So let's try and show you what this thing looks like. Now, we're doing this in the wrong order for pedagogic reasons, right? We're supposed to write the tests first, write down the behavior, then write the code you need. We're going to show a demo of code that already works just to show it off. But just remember, we didn't. That's not the way. So that's the feature we just talked about. Now what we want to do is try to run Cucumber. Oops, where is it? Okay, we're going to do Cucumber, and this is the name add movie feature. Let's try it and see what happens. And it's going to try and look at the features there, see what they can run. So there's the scenario, and then it scrolled by fast. So we ran Cucumber, and we got on the very first step, it's turned red, so that's what we have to fix. So before we can go further, the ones that follow, you can see down here, are in blue because it stops once it finds one in the flap. And it says, I can't find the mapping for the Rotten Potatoes homepage to a path. Now, it's very conversational. Now, go and add a mapping into the path.rb. Here's the full path name so you don't get lost where it is. And add the missing path. Okay? So we will now go to where it's asked for, path.rb here under in My Rotten Potatoes features support paths. All right, so that is right there. And then we look in the file, you can see here is the default page. So we want to add a new entry here, when, and now start at the line. And now what we have to do is pass the. All right, so that's part of it. So this is what we're supposed to do in that web page. And now what we have to do is figure out what to do. And we will go to, I think, over here and run the routes like we did before to see what the mapping is that we're trying to get. And we're looking for the index function. And the index function right here is this is the mapping we need, this is the path we need, is movies, control, shift, copy, and we go back here. Okay, it's all ready. Okay, now, if we write this file, and we go back to, go back here, let's try cucumber again. Cucumber, add the features. So you can see this time it one failed and it skipped them all. The first one failed, it skipped in the 8 steps. It said it took 1.5 seconds. Seems like it'd be taking more. All right. All right, so we saw, if you saw carefully, a green one went by. So this path passed. I am on the Rotten Tomatoes homepage. When I follow add new movie, that passed. The thing that failed, the step that said then I should be on the create new movie page failed. So I'm going to try and copy that again. And it says, what's the error message? Can't find this page. Control, shift. Okay. That's what I'm going to need to have. And it says, once again, go add that mapping to the past.rb. Go back here. Once again. When. Dollar sign, that's the string. Quote, slash. Well, I guess the slash will be there last time. You go back to the rake routes. This time we're doing the new command. It's movie slash new. Okay. And we go try running Cuke again. We had a feature. So two passed. You see at the bottom it skipped 5. So what happens this time? Okay, that looks good, right? If they're all, it says at the bottom here, 8 steps, 8 passed. But this time it found the create music page and was able to do the rest of them. So we successfully, wrote tests for a functionality we already had, and that shows Cucumber at work.